Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Thomas Jones, and we appreciate you attending the final performance of the Granada High School Symphonic Band for the 17-18 school year, our spring performance. Tonight, we present an extremely challenging and spirited program themed Americana. This performance is a wonderful collection of works featuring everything from Civil War songs to jazz, to fanfares and marches. Also tonight, we'll take a moment to recognize and say thank you to our graduating seniors. As many of you know, we held our first annual Department Awards banquet a couple of weeks ago, and we celebrated the success and accomplishment of all of our senior membership. A little later on tonight in the program, and in the interest of time, I will present three departmental awards representing the highest levels of accomplishment in the area of wind instrument performance here at Granada High School. Before we start tonight, I would like to express my gratitude to President Michael Bass and the entire Granada Music Parents organization for their continuous help and support on behalf of all performing groups known as Granada Music. Logistics, equipment, transportation, trucks, uniforms, catering, instruments, and ongoing financial support. A quality, comprehensive high school music program cannot be successful without this support. I ask you to please stay involved in the future. And now I'm grateful to introduce President Michael Bass to say a few words on behalf of the board. Has lasted even with this going on. So, I also want to recognize my longtime friend and a very longtime music educator in the Livermore Schools who is joining us this evening. Please say hello. Many of your students know this man very well. To Mr. Randy Watson. Woo! Marching home as young Americans from North Africa. and South were called from their homes to fight each other. You will hear the sentimental melody just before the battle, Mother, as well as Marching Through Georgia and the Yellow Rose of Texas, stated quite eloquently by the entire tuba section, who never gets melody. The piece culminates with an emotional and powerful rendition of the Battle Hymn of the Republic. We hope you enjoy Jerry Billick's American Civil War Fantasy.
Thank you.
also serve as one reminder of how fragile and precious life is and how intimately connected we are as human beings. Please enjoy an American elegy by Frank Kelly.
Thank you.
cheer. This popular work for concert band by Johnny Warrington highlights the birth of the original Dixieland Jazz Band. The band consisted of five musicians who started out in the Papa Jack Lane Band, a racially integrated group of musicians who played popular tunes, ragtime, and marches for parades, dances, and advertising in New Orleans in the early 20th century. Band leader and cornetist Nick LaRocca argued that the original Dixieland Jazz Band deserved recognition as the first band to record jazz music commercially. This was right around 1918, and the first band to establish jazz as a musical idiom or genre. Tonight, the members of the original Dixieland Jazz Band will be channeled through the performances of our own young musicians. And I'm going to ask you to hold your applause, but please welcome Alec Faith on the trumpet, Bridget Meyer on the clarinet, Santa Simpson on the tenor sax, Andrew DeVita on trombone, and Liam Randalla on the tuba as we present the original Dixieland Concerto by Johnny Warrington. What up, guys?
Thank you.
2005, the normally festive skies over the city of New Orleans began to change. As Hurricane Katrina approached the city, the skies crossed a weather event of unprecedented proportion. Composer Robert W. Smith was commissioned by the United States Marine Corps Band of New Orleans to create this symphonic tone poem, recreating and commemorating the Katrina experience. The piece is titled Promising Skies, but it's subtitled into four sections, beginning with Blue Sky, where the jazz roots of this historic city provide the musical inspiration. Soon, in the next section, Threatening Sky foreshadows the intensity of the events to follow, giving way to Raging Sky, the event of the storm itself. Finally, the dawn of a new sky brings hope as the city is reborn to share its musical gifts with the world once again. The piece was premiered on August 30th, 2009, under the baton of Chief Warrant Officer Michael J. Smith, as the city commemorated the fourth anniversary of Katrina. We hope you enjoy Promising Skies by Robert W. Smith. Make sure that I introduce the featured performers in this piece. I apologize for missing that. This piece will feature, once again, Alec Faith on the trumpet, Adam Lagosinski on trombone, Liam Randhawa on tuba, as well as Miranda Lowe Webb, our oboist, and Vidya Prabhu on keyboard. Now we hope you enjoy Promising Sky by Robert Smith.
Thank you.
just a few moments to recognize and say thank you and offer some accolades as the evening continues. To all of our graduating seniors, I ask that you please stand and be recognized. And I pray one of the most stomach-wrenching things that I face as a school teacher is making sure that I don't miss anybody or have anybody slip through the cracks. Please hold your applause, and I'll introduce them to you one by one. Alexander Bass, Chloe Bennett, Joaquin Cruz Roldan, Andrew DeVita, Andrea Flores, Sebastian Franco, Alejandro Gonzalez, Matt Cromwell, Jamie Larson, Nicholas Lloyd, Jaden Mosby, and Riley Shepard. Please stand up and be recognized.
Thank you.
And I'm really grateful for you putting in the time and effort to do that. So this is our final concert. As I said, tonight is really all about them, so I'm going to ask you to bear with me a little bit longer as I recognize a couple of students for some very special accomplishments. The Instrumentalist magazine is the most respected trade publication in music education. Each year, the editors of that publication sponsor the Instrumentalist Directors Award for BAM. Recipients of this award are recognized for their high level of performance aptitude and achievement, as well as musicianship, service, and dedication to the arts. Please help me tonight congratulate this year's recipient of the Instrumentalist Directors Award for BAM, Miss Chloe Bennett. Sensitivity, expression, and versatility. Please join me in welcoming this year's most outstanding wind musician at Granada High School, Mr. Andrew DeVito. This year's candidate has excelled academically, is a positive force in the Granada High School community, and has excelled in almost every area of our department, including orchestra, symphonic band, marching band, jazz band, and as a soloist. Please join me in welcoming this year's most deserving recipient of the John Philip Sousa Band Award, again, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Andrew DeVito. Approximately 1 week before the 1990 Pacific Grove Band Review. Jenny and a team of about five volunteers were determined and worked seriously hard to get the band and guard, which were in three different uniforms at the time, fitted and ready to debut in early November of 1990. It was an amazing week. Danny, who by then became a tuba player and had taken a very serious interest in the color guard program, graduated in 1992 and immediately began to help with the teaching duties of the color guard. I believe at that time Diane Ward, wife of Junction music director Mike Ward, rest in peace, was the head advisor at that time. Jenny and Danny decided to stay on with the program and the boosters to teach color guard and care for those new uniforms. In fall of 1995, Jenny's daughter Vicky came to us from Junction School as a clarinet player, who then switched to oboe and also took a very serious interest in the color guard. Vicky graduated in 1999, and she immediately began to assist Danny. And I hope, Vicky, I'm getting this right. Who, by that time, Danny had taken over as head instructor of the guard program, and Vicky was assisting him, I believe was the way it went down. And Jenny continued to fill the role of caring for those new band uniforms. After college, Danny eventually moved on to his current job as a public school teacher. Vicky continued to teach the guard until around 2002, and yes, Jenny was still in charge of the Granada band uniforms. By that time, Jenny and I were longtime friends. And there was no doubt that she loved working with the kids. And she decided to stay on as the uniform chairman. I had briefly stepped away from the Granada program and was returning from what I'll just call tonight a sabbatical after teaching a couple of years at East Avenue so I could help my wife more fully care for our two very young children. When I came back to the program, 2004-05, Jenny figured, what the heck, and decided to continue to volunteer as uniform chairman. She just couldn't get enough of those Disney trips. The rest is history, as each and every fall, right up to this year, Jenny and her crew have done an amazing job. First, getting the uniforms professionally cleaned, and then getting them inventoried, prepared, and meticulously fitted to each and every band student who has ever come through the doors of Granada Music. And ladies and gentlemen, by my estimation, that's approximately 3,750 kids wow. since 1998. 30 years. longtime professional educators in California here at Lincoln High School, where Danny is the chairman of the dance department, and Vicki St. Francis. Valley Christian High School, where she also runs dance, and I believe up to this year, color guard, and all kinds of other things. Their endless energy is only good for kids. And God bless both of you, and thank you for coming tonight. I'm grateful to you both. Thank you. All right.
If you're bored, you know where we are.
We are going to close our program this evening with Stars and Stripes Forever, the famous Sousa March. And to the students and families here at Granada High School, I would simply like to say thank you for the honor and privilege of being able to spend more than half my life in that classroom over there working with your sons and daughters. It has been an honor for me, and I will miss each and every one of them. And I'm looking at Rachel over there just saying, you need to let me speak. Come on.
Continues, I'm going to let you all know that I don't get mad, I get even mad. year we had the luck to be placed above a 92 in one of our marching rankings. 92 is a huge, huge record for us, a milestone. It's very hard to get.
I don't remember what interview it is, but it happens.
Mr. Jones promised us that at some point, a couple of things were going to happen. First of all, because we played so well, did so excellent, he was going to get us, this is a direct quote, drunk on Starburst. He never followed through with that promise.
Really? Did he watch you guys more Starburst and show up your lap alone?
American flag.
continue on through his retirement. Sort of retirement. Next year he's going to be working with elementary schoolers. But it's only a year away. So we have to get some things he can enjoy in his retirement. First off, let's see, what is he going to do in his spare time? Well, we have this lovely book that's a
document. I don't play Sudoku, but my wife is smiling
all around me.
You're all you hold.
And then for those nights where he just needs to get out of the house, get some food, a Chili's gift card. A coffee mug. Well, that says, I'm not responsible for anything I say before this cup is empty.
Thank you.
feel almost heartbroken that I'm giving this up and leaving these wonderful young players and musicians. But at the same time, I'm excited and looking forward to new challenges and new events. Because by the time they add my sick leave into this whole thing, I will have been doing this for 37 years. That's enough. Thank you.